I am not a doctor, as you know. I am not an oncologist, but I am a scientist and I'm a teacher. And I want to share something with you today that I think everybody should be aware of so that you have this information which helps you have conversations with your doctors, with your oncologists, if you have cancer or if your loved one has cancer or somebody you know has cancer. They need to understand this because this is really, really interesting and really, really exciting, relatively new science that is in the midst of being researched. Now, when I say new, I mean maybe 4 or 5 years. So I just want to share the information with you. I'm not telling anybody what to do. I am certainly not giving any kind of medical advice. And I would never, ever say that you should not do everything you can to fight cancer if you're in one in a battle like that. Every single avenue for tackling this problem has got to be addressed at the same time, surely. So, welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew Tunstall. I'm a nutritionist. I am a health coach and a lifestyle coach. And I say again, I'm not a doctor and I'm not an oncologist. And this is not medical advice. This is just education, sharing something really, really interesting about the most recent research into cancer. Right. We probably all know by now that cancer is not an infection. It's not something you catch from a virus or a bacteria. There's no magic medicine that's going to kill it because there's nothing to kill. Cancer comes from within you when your own cells start to behave erratically. So something goes wrong. There's usually a trigger. Something goes wrong in the cells and they stop doing the proper job and they start to multiply and eventually multiply out of control, impact the healthy cells around them so your body stops functioning correctly and can lead to organ failure and death. Sometimes you can recover. The therapies that you get, the chemotherapy, the radiotherapy, those can help in your fight, but ultimately it's your own immune system that has to do the job. So, if there are other areas that we can look at which are really going to help, then we need to at least know about them before we decide what we're going to do. What is really, really exciting about research into cancer at the moment is the relatively recent discovery that when your genes mutate and make the cell cancerous, now just for a second here, your body needs to reproduce all the time and constantly make new cells. So let's use a liver as an example. Your liver cells get old and they die and you make new ones all the time. The cells divide in half and you have to make new copies of the DNA with each time that it happens. All right, and the DNA sits in the nucleus of the cell. And that DNA is almost like the recipe for how everything's supposed to function and all the attributes that you have as an individual. So it's another copy and another copy and another copy. And every time you make a copy, there's a risk of a couple of, let's call them typos in the DNA. Most of the time it doesn't matter. If it's something significant and it impacts the cell will probably die. But occasionally, just occasionally, the typo is such that it actually still says something, it's just wrong, and then you have a cancerous issue. So cancer just happens through copying, unlucky when you're copying the DNA. When you do things like get your skin burnt in the sun or putting your hand on a stove, or when you smoke too much and you keep destroying the lining of your lungs, you have to make more copies more often. So you're increasing the risk of that typo coming up and developing cancer. What has been discovered recently is that in 90% of cancers, I mean, that is a lot, 90%, it's actually not your DNA that is wrong. It's the DNA in a little thing inside your cell called a mitochondria. And the mitochondria inside your cell is the only thing in your body that has its own DNA separate from your master DNA. The mitochondrial DNA is not anywhere near as strong and robust as yours. So 90% of these mutations that cause cancer are actually in the mitochondria, not in your DNA. Why does that matter? Because it's the functioning of the mitochondria specifically that gets really badly affected by these cancers. Now, this can be blood cancer, liver cancer, skin cancer, any kind of cancer, because all your cells have mitochondria. And what is showing now in the research is that we all know cancer cells love sugar. What we have discovered, particularly when it's mitochondrial DNA, because the mitochondria are responsible for processing sugar and producing your energy, they suck up massive amounts of sugar, but they are compromised and they cannot process energy from fat. A healthy cell can do perfectly well on fat or sugar. It just depends what your nutrition is like. Fat is actually better. It burns cleaner. You have a more stable energy supply. There are lots of reasons to be eating fat rather than sugar as your energy source. But a cancer cell that has damage to the mitochondria cannot burn fat at all. And it only lives on sugar. So the pharmaceutical companies are spending a lot of money and a lot of time trying to develop a drug that they can then sell, and it will make them a lot of money when they get it right, that will somehow block sugar from going in to a cancer cell, and the cancer cells will die. But they have to allow sugar to go into the healthy cells. So somehow this drug has got to be able to differentiate between a cancer cell and a healthy cell. I would put to you, if that is the case and that is what we're waiting for, why give the cancer cells any sugar in the first place? Change your nutrition, become a fat burner, cut down your carbohydrates, don't supply your body with sugar. Your healthy cells will continue to thrive burning ketones, which come from fat. And your cancer cells, which cannot access the fat, they cannot burn the fat, will have nothing to eat. You'll slow down their growth dramatically. Your other therapies or treatments and your own immune system will be able to get on top of the cancer and break them down faster than they can grow. Because that's just an arms race. If your cancer is growing very quickly and you're chipping away at it with your immune system, but you can't keep up, the cancer is going to win. If your cancer is growing really slowly and you're getting on top of it with your treatments and with your immune system, then the cancer is going to lose. Now, you might have cancer or a cancerous cell, and it will take 10 years before it gets diagnosed because it's one cell, two cells, four cells, eight cells. It needs to be hundreds of thousands before you can pick it up in a test. So I might be sitting here right now with cancer already starting in my body, and I won't have the faintest idea. If I don't eat carbohydrates, I don't eat sugar because I burn fat because I'm on that kind of nutritional program, those cancer cells inside me are already struggling. They will probably just die and I will never even know I had it. Okay, so this is very important information to know. If you have cancer, you have to do everything you can. You speak to your doctors, you speak to your oncologists, you do all the treatments that they recommend, but bear in mind, you can help yourself by not feeding your cancer cells with sugar. And you need to look at some of my other videos, I'll link them here, to understand what sugar is and understand how you can change what you eat so that you don't feed your cancer cells. If you wait for the drug to eventually come that will block the sugar going into your cancer cells, well, that might take another 10 years. Who knows when that's going to be? It'll come. But in the meantime, don't feed the cancer. Thank you for watching. Please share this video. Please subscribe to the channel. And please watch my videos on sugar so you have a better understanding of what sugar actually does and what it actually is. And thank you very much for watching.